Thank you, Madam Speaker. My question is to the Minister for Communications. What challenges does the government face in delivering broadband to the people of remote Western Australia, including the people in my electorate of Durack?
I call the Honourable the Minister for Communications.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I thank the Honourable Member for her question. The Labor Party promised 250,000 Australians that they would be eligible for Labor promised 250,000 Australians they'd be eligible for the interim satellite service, but only bought capacity to service 48,000. They promised the service would deliver 6 megs down, 1 up, for the same price as the City ADSL service. And as the Honourable Member for Durack knows, most of the 5,600 interim satellite users in Western Australia now are getting no better and often worse than dial-up speeds. Kids can't do their homework, farmers can't access the online national livestock identification system, real-time prices or weather services. The $351 million interim satellite service of Labor has been a train wreck. The 45,000 unhappy current customers are costing the taxpayers of this nation $7,300 each in direct subsidy. That is nearly 3 times the level of the old Howard-era Australian broadband guarantee subsidy, and for a much worse service. Now, Madam Speaker, it is our job to clean up Labor's messes, including the Conrovian ones. But I have to say that many, including this one, do not lend themselves to an easy or obvious solution. Indeed, the previous minister washed his hands of this in the last few months of his ministry. Well, here are the measures that we're announcing today. First, at the cost of $18.4 million, the NBN Co will upgrade the current capacity to all users on the satellite service by one-third. Second, we will institute a new stringent fair use policy to ensure a minority of very heavy users cannot crowd out the majority. The NBN Co's trials of these changes demonstrate that even in busy periods, families will be able to answer their emails, surf the web, do their banking, see their kids complete their homework. It will not be as fast as the speeds promised but never delivered by Labor. But it will be broadband and much higher, and certainly not anywhere near the anemic dial-up speeds experienced at present. We are also working on additional measures to provide new services so that at least some of those, about 9,000 in total, who have not been able to get on, will be able to do so. And we'll have more to say about that in coming days when the arrangements are complete. And, Madam Speaker, you might well ask whether these changes, these measures, were not undertaken by the previous minister. Maybe they were suggested to them. But as the former deputy chair of NBN Co today, when I was said Diane Smith-Gander, when asked whether the board had ever suggested to Stephen Conroy should conduct a cost-benefit analysis, she simply said, "Think about the note."
The minister will resume his seat.